Good morning, everyone. In our last class, we have seen how the Boolean operators, they are used in image processing, these things, how to suppress certain part, how to get the region of interest and all these things, right? Now, there is another important aspects or application of this, this Boolean operator, especially the AND operator over here, it is used. AND operator. Okay. So, its application, it is in bit plane slicing. Okay. Bit plane slicing. Right. Now, before getting into the bit plane slicing, we need to know what are bits, right? So, say for example, you are having a 3-bit image. In this case, in this image, you will find that you are having a highest number of 15. That means, how much bit image it should be? It should be a 3-bit image, okay? So, how to convert decimal into bits? So, it is 1, 2, 4, 1, 2 to the power 0, 1, 2, 3, 3, yeah, so 1, 2, 4 and 8, right? So, under this one, if you have to make 10, so it is S plus 2, 10, so 1, 0, 1, 0, right? So, similarly, if you have to get 5, so 4 plus 1, 5, so 0, 1, 0, 1. So, what are these? These are all binary numbers, right? So, we are converting a decimal number into the binary number. So, when we are talking about planes, so what happens is that, see, for the first bit or the 0th bit, we are having a series of numbers for say 10, second was 5, similarly if you do for 8, you should be getting 1, 0, 0, 0. So see, this number is coming. So for each corresponding pixels, you are having 3 planes, 0th plane, 0th bit plane, 1st bit plane, 2nd bit plane and 3rd bit plane. Okay. So, what is this bit plane called? What is this bit plane called? Least significant bit. Right. And what is this bit plane called? Most significant bit. So, the planes which is being formed by the LSB or the 0th bit is called 0 bit plane. If it is used using the this 3, that is the most significant bit, then it is called the 3 bit plane. Okay. So, if you have to create a plane of the most significant bit, you have to take this number corresponding to 10, 5, 8 and so on, whatever the numbers are there. So again, if you look into this plane, this is a binary information. Okay. Now, why the 0th plane, it is called least significant bit? There must be some, fundamentals behind that, right? Why? Usually what happens is that the name itself suggests least significant, okay? So, the least significant information is being carried in the least significant bit. if you are say if you are having an 8 bit image, so the first two planes or first three planes, they may be having the lowest possible information. Okay, lowest possible information is there in basically we are having lowest significant information is being carried by which component of an image? Is it the signal component or the noise component? It is the noise component. So the least information are being carried by the noise component, and because of this, what happens is that if you suppress the lowest bit planes, I am talking about bit planes, you may suppress only one bit plane, you may suppress two bit planes, you may suppress three bit planes. Okay, it upon you, right? If you remember, at the start of the course itself, I told you that image processing is a subjective process. Okay, what information you want, it's you who have to decide. Okay, so what happens over here when I say suppress, say I want to suppress 0th bit plane, so what I should do, I should convert this 0 to 0, this 1 to 0, this 0 to 0. So whatever plane, whatever numbers are there, whether 1 or 0, those will be suppressed to 0. If I want to suppress MSB, then whatever number is there in this plane, in the third bit plane, it would be suppressed to 0. Okay, are you getting my point? So in other words, what you say is that if I am suppressing the lowest bit plane, that means this plane, I am creating an image using 3 bit and 2 bit plane, there will be plane, 3 bit plane and 2 bit plane, and 1 bit plane. Okay, so we are doing ANDing operation, but when we talk about suppressing this lowest bit plane, and if you do not use the lowest bit bit, how will you reconstruct the image? So basically what we do is that AND 0. Are you getting? So this one and this one and this one and this one. No, I am talking about this in this form. Okay, 3 2 1 0. So these are the plane, whatever the values. So you have to put it in this number, right? So like in this one, if you see in the case of 5, so initially in, what you are having 0 1 0 1, but when you are putting it into this thing, I am talking about the planes, I am not talking about the bit numbers over here. Okay, so that means I am not using this plane at all, this number at all, the lowest significant bits number at all. So that whatever is there in this format, it should be 0. That means when I am putting this operator, it would be 0 1 0 0. That means what you are getting, instead of 5 you are getting a value of 4, right? So this is 1 2 4 8, right? So you are getting a value of 4. Similarly, if you take the case of 9, one zero one zero So it sorry 1001, right? So what it gets when you suppress the this thing 1001, so when you suppress this one you get 8. Okay, so you are ending this plane. So because what happens is that corresponding to these numbers, when I say decompose the image into its constituent bit planes, you will be having for a 3-bit image, you will be having 4 planes, 0 bit plane. Right, so corresponding to 10 we are having a value of 0, we will put 0. Corresponding to 5 we are having 1, so we will put 1. Okay, so this is the 0 bit plane. Then first bit plane, for 10 it is 1, then 0, and then so on you will be putting. So you have to make all these planes. Okay, so this is how you do the things. Now I may ask you, suppress the lowest 2 bits. I may ask you, suppress the highest 2 bits. Okay, so you have to then convert those 2 planes into 0 and then again reconvert it into the image. Okay, so first of all, what you have to do whenever you get this kind of question, you have to first make the histogram of the original image itself. What is histogram? You will be having, you have to make a table, gray level, and then you have to make number of pixels. So that would be your histogram. Say 10, so it varies from 0 to 15. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, like this you will get go, and you will find out how many zeros are there. You just find out there is 1 0, so you just put 1. Once, how many ones are there? Calculate this thing, and when you are doing this, make it a habit to strike off the numbers whichever you are counting with a pencil. Okay, because in that way you will be able to keep a track which one you have counted, because sometimes it happens that whenever you are counting you may miss one number, and if you do not keep a track of it, you will be lost. And how to cross-check that whether you have counted or not? Because whenever you are doing in a hurried manner in the exam, you may miss one. Say this 10 you have missed and you have not crossed it, but you will not be able to see it properly in a hurried fashion. So when you sum up the number of the pixels, it should be the total number of pixels over here. So it is nothing but the number of rows multiplied by number of columns. So number of rows is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and columns 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there should be 64 pixel values. So number of the pixels, when you add up, it should come out to be 64. Okay? So keep this in mind. So it will make your life a bit easier. So the first thing what you have to do is to find out the histogram and then plot the histogram. Okay? And then plot the histogram. Once you have done, then do the numerical, like suppress the lowest significant bit. Then again plot the histogram and see what are the changes what you are getting. Okay? So do this. In the first case, you suppress the lowest significant bit, and in the second case, you suppress the most significant bit. And let's see what is the difference. Okay, please do it.